first, we open the EHR app and log in. So select any patient. Under the patient tab, there is a third-party apps. So we select the third-party apps, and here it shows a Physitrack. So we click the Physitrack, and it will take us to the Physitrack. If the user launches has a Physitrack app, and it will take to the patient-specific page, so the users can assign programs to the or exercises to the patient. So that's what we have now.
Okay, so you need a DrChrono account and you need a Physitrack account, and inside the settings page of Physitrack is where you link the two.
Yeah, I think
that's on the web only.
Yeah, that's on the web only, and
for Physitrack.
Yeah. Okay.
So you would go to My Account Settings, and from there we've implemented your OAuth flow, so your OmniAuth 2 flow, where you basically click the Connect to DrChrono button, we then link the DrChrono account to that Physitrack account. And so the change that we're discussing today actually only affects the DrChrono iOS app, where the new functionality is that we've copied the JWT, JSON web token. Anyway, so point is, so we've updated the link on our side. So we use the JWT token to basically replicate the functionalities and also take somebody to either the web app. Only change required, I think, as far as I know, is the updating the URL on your end, where you send along, you link to us.physitrack.com/integration/DrChrono, and then you send along the JWT parameter. And basically then we send you either to our web version if you don't have Physitrack installed iOS, and if it is installed and you're not logged in, we show you that you need to log in first, and if you're logged in, we open the clients list, and if the client is not imported, and there's a kicker, we import the client from DrChrono. That's the sort of the big functionality, is that so you can trigger a patient import from your iOS app as well. That's really the whole kerfuffle that we're talking about right now.
So what's a JWT token?
That's something that you use on your end. Basically, in the old days of the web, we used to use iframes to link things together, right? Like in the old days of Facebook, you had iframes. And iframes are actually not that great in terms of security. So there's something called JWT, JSON Web Tokens, which you're the DrChrono API, if you will, uses to allow third parties like Physitrack to embed into your system. Because it's one long string in the URL. URL is uniform resource locator. It's like going to google.com. It's the address stuff at the top. So it sends it along encrypted, which is safe. And so we've copied that and added some sort of intelligence, if you will, on our side to the link. So if you use that link inside your iOS app, you will get that behavior.
So this is part of our API that we rolled in. JWT tokens, correct?
No, it's up and running.
Yeah, it's,
okay.
It's all up and running. This change was actually requested by, I think, some mutual customers of ours. So, and the pain they were feeling with our old integration is that when they had to first go ahead and import the patient on the web version and then use the iOS version, and that was a hassle for them. So they were like, okay, could you replicate this on the iOS version as well, so that they could take their DrChrono patients and import those via iOS into our backend. So we've done is sort of added some intelligence to the iOS link, if you will, that we gave you, so that now the patient import is automatically triggered, which allows for a truly seamless workflow. And quite frankly, I think it's a pretty unique thing. I don't know any other apps in the iOS. You sort of bounce around data between these two apps the way we do it. That's pretty cool.
And it's a deep link, which is good. The data transfers fully from DrChrono to you guys.